Jews have long been known as the people of the book. They have not, however, been recognized historically as a nation of artists. Centuries of political and economic oppression precluded the development of a Jewish artistic tradition. Although Jews are by no means ascetics, aside from a handful of genre painters, most artists found self-expression in ritual objects and synagogue interiors. Today's interest in fine art Judaica, particularly in representational art, has contributed to a modern-day renaissance that is at odds with the contemporary art world.
Itshak Holtz is arguably the most influential contemporary Jewish genre artist today. His iconic renderings of Jewish life and rituals are instantly recognizable, and his paintings are avidly sought after by discerning collectors worldwide.
I grew up in Poland, in a little town by the name Skierniewice. As I remember it, it was a little town not far from Warsaw and not far from the railroad. I used to love to see the trains going by. I used to go there all the time to look for them. It was to me like something, like a picture. I must have been there about 6 years old. There was, I think, a prime minister. His name was Pilsudski. He had a big mustache, and I used to draw him on the sidewalk with white chalk. People were standing around, admiring, looking, and somehow I was always interested in characters. My father, which was a cap maker, a hat maker, he was also a furrier. And he used to draw very nicely. And he drew for me a picture of a horse and a sleigh, something which I really cherished that. They all knew already that probably I will be an artist. My father's concern was only one thing. Knowing what art is and what artists are, he knew that it's very difficult.
In 1935, 10-year-old Itzhak immigrated to Yerushalayim with his family. This move would prove to be a source of artistic inspiration for him in the years to come.
Yerushalayim, at that time, it's entirely different. There was no such thing as traffic lights or things like that. Entirely something else. I went to a school by the name Tachkimoni in Yerushalayim. That was for me a great break, because every week we used to illustrate the Parashat HaShavua. They selected some of the most talented boys that can really draw. That was for me something unusual. While I studied, I was a good student. But what happened to me? Art took over. I knew that's only one way to, if I continue, to go to an art school. So I went to Betzalel. Betzalel at my time was more of a commercial school. Today it is an academy. And what helped me a lot, we did a lot of commercial work, lettering and poster work to make a little money. That was a very great help.
Although the commercial skills Itzhak acquired at the Betzalel Academy were useful, they didn't satisfy his desire to become a fine art artist. For that, Holtz realized he would need to travel abroad to the United States, to New York City, where he studied at the Art Students League and the National Academy of Design.
It was something for me very, very strange. First of all, I hardly knew the language. The Jews, they're very nice, but they hardly spoke either Yiddish or Hebrew. I had a hard time. Some of them didn't even know what is Surat Aleph. They didn't know. But I got along. I made friends with my teachers. I had two excellent instructors. One of them by the name Robert Brachman, and the other one was Robert Philip. Both of them outstanding artists. I was very much influenced by their work. I met my wife, Ruth Beck. Her father was a shirt maker, and they used to make custom shirts. The only question was always, can you make a living as an artist? So, but I went my way.
During this period, Itzhak primarily painted portraits and street scenes, but his true passion was not being fulfilled. He yearned to return to the scenes of his childhood and create Judaic art.
The subject which I was really mainly interested in is how Jewish artists, how did they tackle that subject? An artist like the Russian Pasternak, Isidor Kaufman, which was a great influence on me. So I kept on trying to see what I can do with those characters. When I went back to Yerushalayim, since I lived in Geula, and not far from Me'ah Sha'arim, I used to see always those cobblers, those shoemakers. I used to go into their stores, look at them, how they work. This somehow grew on me. If they were willing to let me in, I was very happy. And some of them, they said, well, I don't like to have my picture painted. Finally, I found myself models, and I started to work for models. This made the whole change for me. We went to Tzfat. I was simply taken over with that beauty of the old areas, the old cities, going back and forth, and come to these places. I always found something new to paint. Always was never enough for me. Till this day, I never have enough of it.
Itshak Holtz and his wife began to travel back and forth, spending 6 months in Eretz Yisrael and 6 months in the United States. When in Israel, Holtz would set his easel up on location and paint outside.
While I was painting outside, there were always crowds standing over there and looking at my painting, especially when the painting was in progress. Everybody was interested to know if where I studied, or if I sell these things, where do I sell, where are my galleries which I show my work. There was a rabbi over there, was standing and looking at my painting, looks and looks and looks. The painting was in a quite advanced stage. He says, you know, when I see your paintings, I wish that you could continue painting like this to 140 years. So I say, Kvod Harav, we only know about 120 years. But he says, when I see a painting like this, I add another 20 years. I remember an old man was standing. Everybody left already. He comes over to me and says, "You know, I look at this painting and it makes my heart warm." Some of them even told me, "Either you sell me that painting or I'm going to steal it." I pass by here every day and I didn't know that I live in such beautiful place. One day I am walking, I was not too far from Ashurim, and before I know, I see people are gathering for a wedding. Take out my little sketchbook and I started drawing. I come home, I develop it immediately, and from that little drawing became a painting of about a size of about 40 by 60 inches.
While Holtz is perhaps better known for his oil paintings, his drawings are exceptional as well. Itzhak values the immediacy of his sketch and relies on drawing to capture the spontaneity of his scene or likeness. Whether fully developed or loosely rendered, his superbly executed drawings are as powerful as his paintings. Holtz's sketches are very dear to him, so much so he finds it very difficult to part with his drawings.
Drawing is the most important thing. Some of my drawings, which I like them, are very detailed. And some of them I like to be loose. As far as parting with my painting, first of all, as much as I would like to keep many of them, to see my work in other houses, which makes me very, very happy, I ask them sometimes, if I would want to buy something, would you sell it to me? No way. No way. We don't sell it.
To Holtz, a Jewish scene is not merely a scene, but a vision of possibilities. It's not the subject matter that makes Holtz's paintings work. It is his interpretation of the subject that lifts it out of the ordinary. Holtz's art has an integrity to it. He is not merely depicting scenes of Jewish life. This is the life he lives.
It's hard to explain. It comes from hard work, experience. You know, you have to live that life also. You have to live that religious life and also see it, grasp that feeling of Jewishness. It's something that you don't buy. The Betzalel Gallery, which is not only a gallery, it's like a real museum. The lighting, the chandeliers, everything, the setup, all of it is something special. It's not because, I mean, that they sell the art, but they have that feeling for that art. That makes all the difference. You don't just sell a painting. You have to know about it and something which you feel for it. You should be healthy. You should be able to continue the way you do and promote what you're doing for Jewish art, the Betzalel Art Gallery, that it should grow, that people should really enjoy it, and you should have yourself a lot of nachat, briyut, v'hatzlacha, kol tov.
Itzhak Holtz is a man with a vision. The current exhibition of his masterful drawings and watercolors at the Betzalel Gallery offers an opportunity for both collectors and admirers of his work alike to gain a greater appreciation for Mr. Holtz's tremendous virtuosity with all art media.